China of all places. Well, the tomato is the Western red fruit or even the barbarian fruit. And where cocktail tomatoes regularly end up in fruit salads, offers one, well, basically two very similar and yet different recipes with tomatoes, which are some of the most interesting I know because they are extremely simple and make for extremely tasty food and also food where you can recognize just how important the flavor of the ingredients themselves is. One of them, Qi Hong Shi Ji Dan Tang, the tomato egg drop soup. So we need a nice flavorful tomato. If you wanted to, if you cared about it, you could pour some hot water over it and peel it, but you can just as well make it with the peel if you don't care about the harder peel in there, which I personally don't. I like going for the more rustic way of doing things. I will also be working with some olive oil. This is not the most usual way in China, well, no olives, but it is becoming more popular since also there it's supposed to be healthy. It's known as something supposed to be healthy, and I think it's pretty nice for the flavor. Quite a good shot is good here. This actually peels nicely, so I'm just going to peel some of it at least. If it offers itself like that, then why not? This is going to be Qi Hong Shi Ji Dan Tang, so soup, so we need quite a bit of water. The tomato is getting fried a bit. By the way, here I'm not using my wok, because it is an iron wok, and in this dish it can impart some of an iron-like flavor, so it's not good for that. Before this turns into too much of a soup just by itself, I will want to add the water, salt it, bring it to a boil again, and then drop in the egg, mixing it to get the nice threads of egg that such a soup should have. And this, since it is a soup, is a very good meal, a very good dish rather, to prepare as the first part of a meal, at least the first part which you cook, because of course there is enough water in it with it that it will retain the heat for a long time, so you can let it sit while you do other things then. And it's just too fascinating, because basically it's the oil, the salt, and the flavor of the tomato, and a bit the flavor of the egg, which gives this all its flavors, and yet already makes it a very nice soup.